Hello, Dwayne. It's Rose, your neighbor. I know it's late, and I know that I tend to be a little anxious about small things. I apologize for that, but I'm getting a bit worried. I haven't seen you out of the house in about 3 weeks. Is everything all right? Could you call me just to let me know everything's fine? All right. Bye-bye.
Absolutely celestial. The temperature won't drop below 77 degrees, and it's going to be one hell of a sunny day. Get your sunscreen towels out and take your whole family to the beach. Take a day off and show your loved ones how much you care about them on this wonderful vacation. On another note, today we got a special guest with us, and we're going to have a lot of fun with him. His name is Dwayne Anderson. His family. Thank you.
Stay with me, Missy. It's bad, Missy. It has to go away. Don't tell anyone, Missy. Me and you. I want to help you. It's not what it seems, Missy. Your parents wouldn't understand, Missy. Only you can understand. Get rid of it, Missy. Do it, Missy.
Supper's ready! Come on up! Lucy? Why would she do that? She loved Pico!
I don't know. She's never done anything like it. I think we should see a professional. Diagnostic. She could be in danger. We don't have much of a choice.
I know all that! But who the hell prescribes syringes for a child? Couldn't they just give us pills like everyone else? How can a child trust a parent that thrusts needles up their arms? This new doctor clearly doesn't know anything about parenting. I don't want their help anymore. She's only been worsening ever since we went to these doctors. Imaginary friends and all these weird behaviors. She doesn't even call me Mom anymore!
They're just trying to help. It's not their fault. Even before we sought their help, she had problems. She killed Pico for fuck's sake! Don't you remember?
Open that goddamn door now! Move! Morris's symptoms are aggravating. Doctors tell me it's become very hard to pinpoint the exact disorder. They tell me she's got symptoms of schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, psychosis, dementia, and more. I don't know what to do anymore. It feels like the treatments are only making things worse. Today she told me she often hears her own voice whispering a sequence of 5 numbers through the baby monitor. She said it's the key to her inner house. What does that even mean? What am I supposed to do?
Thank you. Bring me my child.
Huh.
What took you so long, George? You know when tea time is, and yet you always find a way to be late. Were you in your study room again, scribbling nonsense and talking to your recorder? I'm beginning to think you love your work more than me. I know you tire of me. Oh, yes. I know you'd have me gone in a heartbeat if you could. It's just fine. I'm sorry. I'm just tired. Would you be a doll and fetch me some of my special tea? You know where it is. I'll wait here, George.
Thank you.
Iris now has moments of severe psychosis. She loses contact with reality for long periods of time. She hardly remembers me anymore. She's lost her trust in me, and it's becoming harder and harder to administer her treatments. She sometimes forgets where she is, or even the fact that she has to wear clothes. She keeps on scratching her nails or banging her head on doors. She murmurs gibberish sentences and roams aimlessly around the house. The other day, she even accused me of trying to poison her. I'm on the edge. I don't think I can take much more of this. How am I supposed to work, take care of the baby, and deal with her dementia all at the same time? I fear that Dolores is getting worse by the day. Her temperaments are extremely bipolar. She gets easily upset over small things, almost always immediately followed by self-resentment and the asking for forgiveness. It's getting harder to cope with her outbursts, but my love for her is strong still, and I'll do whatever it takes to help her overcome her condition. Oh, no. I'm gonna be late for tea. Where did I put that damned attic hook?
I knew it. I'll show you, you damned scoundrel, what bread you're worth.
Thank you. Thank you. What the fuck is this? Oh, it better not be what I think it is!
You fucking bastards.
What is this? Who the fuck are you?
Get me that easily, huh? Nice try, you fucks! What the fuck do you want, huh? I'm right here!
Those little fucks. You think you can find one of me?
Don't you fucking move, I swear to God! Stop right there! What? What?
Smith?
Yes, sorry, I'm with you.
I have the information you requested concerning the patient that came in tonight. He claims that someone broke into his house and tried to strangle him, and that he used his firearm in an attempt to defend himself. What's weird is that there's nothing in the police report that indicates any break-in. There are some minor bruises on his body, but they all seem self-inflicted. The police also interrogated the neighbor who called the police. She claims to have seen him tossing books from his bookshelves frantically, seemingly searching for something.
And what was he searching for?
It's hard to tell. He refuses to answer most of our questions, claiming we already know the answers. He believes we're partly responsible for what happened. It's not really surprising. I took a look at his medical background, and he's had really bad cases of...
scopophobia.
Exactly.
Thanks, Tim. I'll go and see him right away.
Of course. He'll be in the transit wing, room 323 until further notice. He seems agitated. So be careful.
Thanks, Tim. Duly noted.
Lost it.
Leave me
alone. Inject him with a tranquilizer.
I'm not supposed to be here. You're all.
Someone bind him up.
Get his doctor right away.
Let me out of here.
You have assaulted multiple employees and threatened security guards with a knife. You sabotaged the electric panel, leaving the entire ward under lockdown. Such behavior is leaving us questioning your mental stability and health. We are left with no choice but to isolate you from the patients and employees in the psychiatric ward. Treatments are in measure.
No treatments! You all are the reason why this. but...
Thank you.
So, Reagan, right? I'm here with good news. Based on your behavior and recovery in the past few months, you'll be ready to leave and go home. Sounds good, right? There are just a few technicalities that need to be taken care of, but this will just take a couple days. With everything that happened, I'm sure you'll be very happy to leave this place. Well, I'll get back to you soon.
Everything I know, I'll definitely take them down. You hear me, fuckers? I'm on to you!
Hey, what are you doing? Who sent you? Wait!
No! Fuck!
All right, Sarah, it's time for bed now.
Daddy? I want a story.
I think it would be great if you told her a bedtime story, Dwayne. It's been a while.
Daddy?
Are you just going to ignore her? Always ignoring us, glued to your fucking beers. You don't talk, you don't sleep in the bedroom, you don't get out at all, you just don't care, do you? Why don't you just leave?
Mom.
Why are you like that? Talk to me. You used to be so good to us.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, Dwayne! Welcome to your domain! I was waiting for you impatiently. What? You tell me this isn't your domain? Nonsense! It's the fruit of your hard labor! Can't you see how everyone enjoys their time here? It's all thanks to you they have this newfound home! How fulfilled they all seem! Some of them might look a little lost, I concur, but what of it? They have a place to be for all of eternity! How delightful for them, courtesy of Dwayne Anderson. The dead will whisper tales of your achievements, and you will be remembered forever. Now, up you go, chap. Go have a look at your masterpiece.
Explain this to me. Please talk to me. I love you, Dwayne. I want to help you. First the alcohol and now this? Who prescribed you this and why? I want to know so I can help you through it. Are you slowly going insane, Dwayne? Should we be worried? Because we are. Recently, you've been scaring everyone with your cold indifference. Are you thinking of leaving us? What do you want to run from so bad that you drug yourself every day? Do you want to die, Dwayne?
I could help you with that, you know? I'm only with you because you have money. It's probably blood money, but I don't care. I don't care about you.
If you want to die, I'll happily oblige.
Do you want a rope?
Want me to kick the bucket? Life would be so much easier without your mopey face around, you delusional fuck. Want me to stab
you with seven knives?
Want me to rip the jaw off your ugly face? How about I break both
your legs and leave you to rot in a cellar?
You're a disgrace. People despise you. I despise you. Your children despise you. You're horrifying.
You should die.
You know what? Forget it. I don't want to help you die. Do it yourself. I won't help you into release. Kill yourself by yourself alone. And go to hell where you belong!
Flying. Angel. Blue. Free. Cuddles. Decontamination. Coffee. Game. Apple. Monkey. Banana. Genocide.
Why, hello there, chap. I've been waiting for you for quite some time now. You're my friend, aren't you? Care to share a drink with me? What a look you have! Are you tired somehow? I getcha. It's hard to rest in this place, isn't it? Yes, I know. I've been here for quite some time, you know. And I'm glad you came along. But hey, we're here to talk about you, right? Never mind my foolish burdens and talk to me. So, you feel confused, don't you? I understand. Everything has been really blurry since you woke up, hasn't it? Do you even know your own name, old friend? Dwayne, of course! There's no mystery here. But I can see that you are wondering if this is real after all. I can assure you, although this might not reassure you, that it is very real. In fact, one might say that this is the first time you're facing reality. No, no, don't look at me like that. I'm on your side, Dwayne. We've been friends for so long, after all. Who am I? Ah, you've always been like this, haven't you? Always asking the wrong questions. Dwayne, listen to me here. The real question isn't who am I, but who are you? Dwayne, but that is nothing but a name, my friend. I'm not asking about a name, I'm asking about who you are. Now, Dwayne, shush a little bit and take a sip. Remember, you and me, we go a long way. I'm on your side. Why don't we take a little sip to our friendship?
Cheers.
If you want me to help you, I've got to know something. Are you a fucking murderer? No? Well, what could be the reason behind all that drinking and drugging then? What's up with you? Oh. You've been seeing things, you say? Things, Things like that? Don't you worry, my friend. Just take a sip, and everything's gonna be back to normal. Go ahead. Drink a little of this wonderful poison. It'll do you real good. I would advise you to take that drink now, my friend.
Cheers.
See? Ain't that sweet? You know you can always rely on this to get you back on track, don't you? Yeah, you remember the coarse taste that burns and slides down your throat, ominously bringing relief and the dulling of your senses? Come on, take another sip. You know you want it.
Cheers.
And another sip.
Cheers.
Now, Dwayne, will you fucking tell me who you are? What a look you have! Are you tired somehow? I getcha. It's hard to rest in this place, isn't it? Yes, I know. I've been here for quite some time, you know. And I'm glad you came along. But hey, we're here to talk about you, right? Never mind my foolish burdens and talk to me. So, you feel confused, don't you? I understand. Everything has been really blurry since you woke up, hasn't it? Do you even know your own name, old friend? Dwayne, of course! There's no mystery here, but I can see that you are wondering if this is real after all.
Thank you. Oh, my God.